Okay, we'll start with the new chapter, design of cranes, in which first we will concentrate on classification of cranes and then design of hook first. Then we will move on. So, classification of cranes. There are broadly two types of classification. One is given by CMAA, that is Crane Manufacturers Association of America, and second one is given by BIS, Bureau of Indian Standards. Okay, so first have a look at the CMAA classification. Okay, according to CMAA, they have classified the cranes in class A, B, C, D up to class F. So class A, okay, before going to that, I think you know what is crane. Crane is basically a machine which is used to lift heavy loads and to move them to required position. Cranes में भी बहुत सारे टाइप्स आते हैं. दिस वन इज ओवरहेड क्रेन. ऑन ग्राउंड क्रेन्स आर ऑल्सो अवेलेबल. पर्पज ऑफ द क्रेन्स इज सिंपली टू मूव द लोड फ्रॉम वन पोजिशन टू अनदर पोजिशन. So according to CMMA, class A cranes are standby service cranes. What do you mean by standby? Means they will not be used repeatedly. They will be used only when the maintenance work is to be carried out or any pump or element, machine element is damaged, then we have to replace that element. At that time only, these class A cranes are used. So based on this criteria, standby service, it is classified as class A. It is not in constant use, used only during erection and servicing. And cranes permits 2 to 5 lifts per hour. Okay, now what is 2 to 5 lifts? Lift means lifting the loads. So you can see the frequency of lift is very low. So they are standby cranes. They are used in powerhouse, pump room, motor room. Okay, in that applications only it is used, where your use is not repeated. Then class B is light service crane. They are floor operated cranes, not overhead. They are floor operated. So फ्लोर पे मूव करती है. दे आर ऑल्सो नॉट इन कॉन्स्टेंट यूज, बट दिस टाइम दे परमिट 5 to 10 लिफ्ट पर आवर. सो फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ लिफ्टिंग इज मोर एज कंपेयर टू क्लास ए क्रेन. दे आर यूज इन रिपेयर शॉप, लाइट असेंबली वर्क एंड सर्विस बिल्डिंग्स. देन थर्ड क्लासिफिकेशन इज क्लास सी, और मॉडरेट यूज इन मॉडरेट सर्विस. दे आर कैब ऑपरेटेड क्रेन यूज एट प्लेसेस. ओके, नाउ कैब ऑपरेटेड मीन्स देर इज वन सेपरेट कैबिन फॉर ऑपरेटर टू ऑपरेट द क्रेन. ऑपरेटर इज सिटिंग एट सम डिफरेंट प्लेस देन क्रेन. कैन इट इज ऑपरेटिंग द क्रेन फ्रॉम दैट कैबिन, यू कैन से. This crane permits 5 to 15 lifts per hour and used in machine shops, assembly shops, foundries, fabrication shops, etc. And fourth one is class D. They are heavy duty service, used in heavy duty service. These are again cab operated. Okay. Class B जो था वो floor operated था. Class C and D are कैब ऑपरेटेड क्रेन. दे क्लास बी परमिट्स अप टू 20 लिफ्ट पर आवर. सो यू कैन ऑब्जर्व इन क्लासिफिकेशन द मेजर डिफरेंस इज सिंपली दिस फ्रीक्वेंसी ऑफ यूज इज इंक्रीजिंग. इन क्लास ए 2 to 5 लिफ्ट वर परमिटेड, इन क्लास बी 5 to 10, इन क्लास सी अप टू 15, इन क्लास डी अप टू 20 लिफ्ट पर आवर. दे आर यूज इन हैवी ड्यूटी मशीन शॉप्स, like foundries, fabrication plants, stamping plants, field warehouses, etc. Then class E is severe duty service. They are also cab-operated cranes used for continuous material handling. Okay, now this class E will be used continuously for material handling. They permit 20 to 40 lifts per hour. तो आप देख सकते हैं कि इन 1 आवर दे आर लिफ्टिंग 40 टाइम्स. तो दीज आर इन कंटिन्यूअस यूज्ड इन सीमेंट प्लांट्स, कोल हैंडलिंग प्लांट्स, फर्टिलाइजर प्लांट्स टू मूव दीज थिंग्स. एंड द फाइनल वन इज क्लास एफ और स्टील मिल सर्विस, स्पेशली यूज्ड इन स्टील मिल्स ओनली. दे आर कैब ऑपरेटेड क्रेन्स and permits 40 to 50 lifts per hour and used in steel mills. This is the classification given by CMAA, Crane Manufacturers Association of America. In exam, it is asked in 4 marks. They classify the cranes. Then another classification is given by BIS, Bureau of Indian Standards. So according to BIS, we are classifying cranes in 4 classes. First one is light duty crane, second is medium duty, third is heavy duty, and fourth is extra heavy duty. So in class 1, light duty cranes, normal maintenance cranes which are not in constant use. This is the classification given by BIS. Okay, so these cranes class 1 is not in constant use and designed for maximum of 1000 hours. The life of this class 1 crane is 1000 hour only, and which is good because it is not repeatedly used. Only when maintenance work is to carry out, at that time only it will be used. And these cranes permit 15 lifts per hour. They are low speed and lightweight cranes. Then class 2 is medium duty. These cranes are designed for maximum of 2000 hours. The life of this crane is 2000 hours. And this permits 25 lifts per hour and used in industries, workshop, foundries, warehouses. तो जो क्लास वन है उससे थोड़ा ज्यादा काम करेगी, तो मीडियम ड्यूटी. देन हैवी ड्यूटी परमिट्स 26 to 35 लीटर पर आवर एंड यूज्ड वेयर मटेरियल हैंडलिंग इज अ पार्ट ऑफ रेगुलर प्रोडक्शन प्रोसेस. मींस दिस क्लास 3 क्रेन्स आर इन कंटिन्यूअस यूज. Then class 4 is extra heavy duty cranes. They are also in continuous operation and used in steel industry, cement industry, and coal plant. So these are the classifications given by BIS, Bureau of Indian Standards. Light duty, medium duty, heavy, and extra heavy duty. So now let's quickly look at the components of EOT crane, because in our syllabus the concentration is on EOT cranes, design of hook and wire drum of EOT crane. Now what do we mean by EOT? EOT means electric overhead traveling crane. You can see it is figure on right hand side. This is the AutoCAD drawing prepared by me while I was working in industry. So you can see in this warehouse, this crane is over here. So all the work will be going on downside. All the machines will be installed over here on bottom of this warehouse. And this crane is on top of this warehouse. दिस ट्रेन विल बी ट्रैवलिंग ओवर हेड, सो दैट इज व्हाई द नेम इज गिवन एज ओवर हेड ट्रैवलिंग ट्रेन एंड दिस इज ऑपरेटेड बाय इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, दैट इज द इलेक्ट्रिक ओवर हेड ट्रैवलिंग ट्रेन. सो व्हाट आर द कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ दिस? फर्स्ट वन इज गर्डर, ये जो सेंट्रल बीम है इट्स कॉल्ड गर्डर, विच विल टेक द लोड, विच लोड दिस क्रेन इज एक्चुअली लिफ्टिंग सम लोड फ्रॉम हियर बॉटम, यहाँ से कुछ लोड पिकअप करेगा, तो वो लोड कौन सस्टेन करेगा? ये गर्डर. जनरली क्रॉस सेक्शन ऑफ दिस गर्डर इज आई, आई टाइप क्रॉस सेक्शन इज प्रिफरेबल इन दिस गर्डर. सेकेंड कंपोनेंट इज हॉइस्ट. हॉइस्ट इज बेसिकली अ डिवाइस विच विल मूव द लोड अप एंड डाउन. ये जो हॉइस्ट है उसके अंदर वायर ड्रम अटैच किया होता है, विद द हेल्प ऑफ दैट वायर ड्रम वी कैन लिफ्ट द लोड और मूव द लोड अप एंड डाउन. सिंपली कीप दिस थिंग इन माइंड, दिस हॉइस्ट इज अ कंपोनेंट विच इज यूज टू मूव द लोड अप एंड डाउन. देन केबल मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम to provide the electricity to this hoist motor, this cable management system is installed. Then LT motor. Now what do you mean by LT? LT means long travel motor. So this motor will move the crane throughout our warehouse. Warehouse में warehouse के front portion से back portion. Suppose this is the warehouse and this is the rail installed for moving the crane and this is the crane. I am showing the side view of this thing. So to move the crane from front to back or back to front of the warehouse or to cover the whole space available in warehouse, this LT motor, long travel motor, is installed. The next portion is or component is end carriage. It simply supports this girder and this end carriage will move on the rails. So these are the components of EOT crane. Now we will focus mainly on this hoist. And in that hoist also we will mainly focus on hook. So this one is single girder crane. And here in this picture we have shown double girder EOT crane. In single girder crane, the hoist is actually hanging on downside of this girder, and in double girder crane this hoist is crawling over this girder. ये जो दोनों girder होंगे उसके ऊपर भी एक rail बनाई होगी और उस rail के ऊपर ये hoist है वो move करेगा. So you can see the motions. This hoist can move left and right in this span, and this LT motor will move this whole crane. ये जो पूरी क्रेन है उसको मूव करेगी LT motor. So this is a typical drawing of a hoist which is used to move the load up and down, which is hanging over here. You can see this drawing was also prepared by me while I was working in Loadmate. You can see different components of this hoist also, very detailed components. There are two motors installed in hoist. One motor is attached with this roller, because in this crane you can see we have to move this hoist left or right. Okay, so to move this complete hoist, we have attached this motor and second motor over here will move the rope drum or rotate the rope drum to lift the load. So let's have a look at the components of it. First one is hook assembly. Okay, hook assembly means this hook as well as this pulley assembly. Second, pulley system. Third, rope drum. This is the rope drum on which rope will be wound, okay, or unwound depending on whether we are lifting the load or lowering the load. Fourth one is cross travel motor. Okay, this cross travel motor will move this complete hoist left or right in our warehouse. Fifth one is hoisting motor. Hoisting motor will rotate this rope drum or wire drum to lift the load. Sixth one is trolley wheel. These are the wheels with the help of which this hoist will be moving. So these are the components of a hoist. Now let's have a look at the components of crane hook assembly with pulley. So now we will concentrate on these components. So this is the detailed drawing of crane hook assembly. You can see over here this component is hook, that is crane hook. Then cross piece for hook. Okay, this hook is actually attached with this or supported with this cross piece, because we are required to move this hook down or lift this hook up. So to move this hook, we have to attach this hook with pulleys. So these are the supporting arrangements for connecting hook and pulley. The cross piece is the element on which our hook is supported. Another component is thrust bearing. A nut for hook. Okay, this hook will be attached with the help of nut, washer, and lock nut, and shackle plate. Shackle plate will carry the main load, okay, because this load is acting on hook. Okay. This hook will transfer the load to this shackle plate. Through this cross piece. And side plate and pulley axle. This axis is pulley axle. And spacer to maintain the space between pulley and this plate. We have used spacer. And pulley bearing and finally pulley. These are the components of a crane hook assembly. You can see how detailed it is. In design data book, the equations for all these components are available. But mainly, the design of hook is concentrated. Okay, so let's have a look at design of crane hook. Crane hook ka design dekhte hai. Okay, I have taken this data or equations from PSG design data book. The same equations are available in PSG design data book as well as design data book by VB Bhandari. So this is a hook, figure of hook. In this, RG is the radius of centroid or geometric radius, and Rn is the radius of neutral axis. Now one will get confused why two radius are given, because what we have learned in bending, okay, this crane hook is actually acted upon by load P. Okay, this load will induce bending stress in this beam as well as direct stress. So you can analyze these hook stresses in this hook can be analyzed by the theory of curved beam. In book, curved beam. So if you want to refer the equations for stresses in book, how the equation comes, then you have to study this theory, curved beam. So in simple straight beams, we have studied the equations for straight beam. Okay, in straight beam, what was happening? The centroidal axis and neutral axis were overlapping on each other. Okay, they were overlapping on each other. But in case of curved beams, the centroidal axis and neutral axis will not overlap. The neutral axis will shift towards this curvature. So there will be this difference between neutral axis and centroidal axis in case of hook or curved beam. So first element is bed diameter. You can see here it is highlighting C. Okay. So C is the bed diameter, or you can say inside diameter of this hook. An equation of it is C is equal to x under root P in mm, where P is taken in kilonewton and x is the constant ranging between 12 to 24. So this equation is taken from data book. P is equal to x under P, where you have to consider P over here in kilonewton. So P is the inside diameter or bed diameter or seat diameter. Next one is throat of hook J. You can see here throat of hook J. J is, you can say, opening available over here. So J is given as 0.75 C in mm. Okay, all these data are from design data book, so you are not required to remember or memorize this equation. If it is asked in exam, then you simply open the data book and write this equation and simply substitute the value, and you will get 7 marks. Throat of hook J is equal to 0.75 C in mm. Then depth of cross section H, this nomenclature you must know, H over here. So H is depth of this cross section, or height of cross section you can also say. So H is equal to 0.93 C in mm. And width of the cross section, width of the cross section BI is equal to 0.65 H in mm. And Radius of intrados and extrados. Now, what do you mean by intrados? Intrados means the surface on inner side. Okay, this hook is having two surfaces. One is on inner side and another surface on outer side. Okay. So, intrados means inner surface and extrados means outer surface. So, radius of intrados is equal to 0.5 c. You can see the inner diameter is actually c, so radius will be half of c, 0.5 cm. And radius of extrados, ro, is equal to inner radius plus height. This inner radius plus height, so ro is equal to, or outside diameter, or outside radius, or radius of extrados is equal to 0.5 cm + h in mm. Then core diameter of the shank of crane hook DC over here. So now you can see this core diameter can be found using the equation of this stress. So as I said that this hook is acted upon by load P. So two types of stresses will be induced. One is bending stress in this portion because this is curved portion, and normal stress. I showed you that this hook is supported by a plate and it is attached with the nut. So in this portion over here, the direct stress will be induced. So stress over here is equal to load by area. Simple definition of stress is load by area. So P by AC. So from this equation you can find this cross sectional area is the cross section of this area is given to you, circular or rectangle, whatever. So from that you can find out this core diameter or width, and you all know this equation also. Sigma is equal to allowable stress divided by factor of safety. Next is parameter of triangular cross section. Here the cross section of the crane is shown. This cross section is shown over here. So first, RG is the geometric radius or centroidal radius. RN is the neutral radius of neutral axis. On right hand side you can see this is intrados, means this surface is on inner side, and extrados is on outer side. And in this cross section also, you can see two radiuses are available. One is about 0.01 and second one is about 0.02. So R1 is the radius of this inner surface or a cross section of inner surface. So R1 is equal to 0.75 h in mm, and R2 is equal to 0.125 h in mm. So O1 and O2 is equal to 0.125 h. So now let's have a look at the bending stress in crane hook. As I said that if we apply simple load on this curved beam, then bending stress will be induced in this beam. So we have to analyze from that angle. Bending stresses are given by this equation. Okay. In simple beam, You know the equation of bending is equal to sigma is equal to m y by I. You know this equation. If the beam is straight, but here our beam, the hook, okay, we are treating hook as a beam. Our beam is actually curved. So at that time we have to use this equation. So sigma b at intrados, okay, bending stress on inner side is equal to m h divided by a e r a. This is on inner side, that is why we are considering distance h I and radius r I, radius of intrados. And on inner surface there will be tensile stress, because if you consider this beam, curved beam like this, so on inner surface there will be tensile stress, because if you apply the load over here, you can see that inner surface is actually stretching, and compressive stress will be generated on outer surface. The same way we are doing in this. Sorry, opposite. So on inner side there will be tensile stress, and on outer side there will be compressive stress in case of hook. So that is why the stress as at intrados is taken as positive, that is tensile stress, and at extrados it is taken as negative because it is compressive. So stress on extrados is equal to m h o a e r o, where m is the bending moment about centroidal axis. Keep this thing in mind. Okay, while calculating the moment in example, you have to take the radius of centroidal axis, because it is the moment about centroidal axis, about this axis. So bending moment m is equal to p into r g. Simple equation of moment, force multiplied by distance. So p into r g, and a is the cross sectional area in mm square. Now in examples this cross section area is changed from different year. Okay, in one year you are given take trapezoidal cross section area, in another year you are asked to take triangular area likewise. And this data of these all areas are available in design database. Ri is the radius of inner surface of crane hook. Keep one thing in mind, this r1, r2, ri, ro are different things. Don't confuse. Okay. If you are asked to find ri, then don't use this equation. Ri, ro, r1, r2 are different things. Okay. These r1 and r2 are radiuses in cross section, while ri and ro, this ri and ro is the radius of hook, curvature of hook, you can say radius of curvature of this hook. Don't get confused in that. Hi is the distance of innermost surface from neutral axis. Okay. ये जो न्यूट्रल एक्सिस है वहां से innermost surface, this much distance is Hi. And the distance of outermost surface from neutral axis is Ho. And E is the distance between the, or you can say difference between these two radiuses, R N and R G. So this is the stress distribution in the cross section of the hook. On inner side there will be tensile stress, on outer side there will be compressive stress. So total stress at intrados will be equal to normal stress plus bending stress, and total stress at extrados is equal to again normal stress plus bending stress. In case of intrados, the bending stress is positive, so that will be added. While in case of extrados, this bending stress is negative, so that is why it will be subtracted. So now, based on these equations, we will solve the examples in next lecture.